Hi, I am Ravi Kumar, a maths facilitator training young minds. Today, let us have two types of academic standards which are reflecting in the Telangana State Board 10th class maths exam. As you know very well, Telangana State Board is following CCE pattern. So, in connection with the CCE pattern, they set up some academic standards in mathematics, and based on this academic standards only they set the paper and the questions will reflect according to the weightage. So let us select today two academic standards. One is reasoning and proof, and second one is community, means connection. Okay, so coming to the reasoning and proof, most of you face some difficulties in geometry, but geometry is nothing but a pictorial or figurative representation, and if you apply some algebraic concepts then it will be very easy. So today let us have one problem. Consider a right angle triangle. So a right angle triangle, usually one right angle and longest side. So here in triangle ABC, angle C is equal to 90 degrees, and the longest side opposite to this right angle is AB hypotenuse. Usually this BC side is represented by a small letter A, that is length of the side, and AC side represented by small b, that is the length of the side, and AB side represented by C. So you have to follow the notations here very carefully. Let small a, small b, small c represents the length of the sides in right angle triangle ABC respectively. Now, a perpendicular is drawn from C to the hypotenuse, that is CD. So CD is the perpendicular drawn from vertex C to the hypotenuse AB, and length of this perpendicular is P. Now, the entire information given in this question is ABC is a right angle triangle with angle C is equal to 90 degrees, and AB is the longest side hypotenuse. Small a, small b, small c are the length of the sides respectively. That means you have to follow the notation. BC side represented by A, and AC side represented by B, and AB side represented by C. And there is a perpendicular is drawn from vertex C to AB, that is CD, and length of the perpendicular is P. Now what we have to prove is first condition, PC is equal to AB, and second one is most important, 1 by P square is equal to 1 by A square plus 1 by B square. Now both of these conditions we apply two individual conditions of the triangle. One is area of a triangle. As you know very well, polygon, area, triangle, half into base into height, and in particular right angle triangle, we will have area of the right angle triangle is half the product of the sides containing the right angle, because if you treat this BC as the base and the corresponding perpendicular or height is nothing but AC, that's why you will get directly the product of the perpendicular sides in right angle triangle. And secondly, a very popular and famous known theorem related to right angle triangle, that is Pythagoras. So what is actually Pythagoras? The square of the hypotenuse in a right angle triangle is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. So we will apply Pythagoras for this right angle triangle. AB is the hypotenuse, so AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square. Now coming to the notation, this is C square is equal to A square plus B square. We can make use of this condition, C square is equal to A square plus B square, wherever necessary. Now coming to the first property, we have to prove that PC is equal to AB. Now area of triangle ABC, first one time I am taking it is a right angle triangle. So as I told you, half the product of the sides containing the right angle. So 1 by 2 into, treat this BC as the base and the corresponding height is AC. So 1 by 2 into A into B. This is AB by 2 square units. Clear? Now, the same triangle I will apply in another way, that is geometrical area, half into base into height. So again, area of triangle ABC. This time I will take AB as the base. So 1 by 2 into AB base. What is the corresponding height? Corresponding height is CD, because we draw perpendicular from opposite vertex C to the side AB. Now this is in notation. AB is nothing but small c, and CD is the perpendicular P. So it is PC by 2 square units. That means we got area of triangle ABC in two different cases. One is half into BC into AC, and another one is half into AB into CD. But remember one point here, a closed geometrical figure will have a unique area. That means once if you decide the area of triangle ABC, it exists uniquely a positive integer. That means both these areas must be equal. Therefore, AB by 2 is equal to PC by 2. Cancelling on both sides 2, we will get the condition PC is equal to AB. That means what you observed from this particular problem, everybody knows that area of a triangle in only one way, half into base into height. Okay, well, very good. Half into base into height is no doubt the area of the triangle. But here we have taken a right angle triangle. So right angle triangle area can be also measured half into product of the sides containing the right angle. That means we have taken the area in two ways. Anyhow, area is the unique. That's why we equated both conditions and we got this relation. So this kind of problems are called reasoning and then proof, right? Now there is a second part. We have to prove that 1 by p square is equal to 1 by a square plus 1 by b square. So for that we will apply very simply. This is pc is equal to ab, squaring on both sides, p square c square is equal to a square b square, right? Now this c square is multiplying here, take into the right side, p square is equal to a square b square by c square, right? Now actually I required left hand side 1 by p square. So that is the reciprocal of p square. That means when you equate two fractions on both sides, if you reciprocate as they are non-zero terms, automatically here by 1, so it will become 1 by p square is equal to c square by a square b square. And this particular process is called ratio proportion reciprocal. That means p square by 1 is equal to a square b square by c square. Automatically 1 by p square is equal to c square by a square b square, because here p square is a non-zero term, it's a perfect square, and a square b square also non-zero terms. As we are dealing with the length of the sides of the triangle, obviously they are non-zeros. Clear? Now this is 1 by p square is equal to, just now I told you AB square is equal to AC square plus B square. This is because of right angle triangle Pythagoras property. So C square is equal to A square plus B square. I will replace C square with A square plus B square by A square B square. Now this is a plus. Only numerator is addition and denominator is common for both the terms. You can split into two terms. A square by A square B square plus B square by A square B square. Now 1 by p square is equal to, you can cancel a square here, b square here, 1 by b square plus 1 by a square. Write in a particular order, 1 by p square is equal to 1 by a square plus 1 by b square. This is also a numerical condition we got based on the Pythagoras principle of triangle ABC. So this is 1 by p square is equal to 1 by a square plus b square. So like this questions, they will reflect in paper 2, Telangana State Board.